Every month about 100 students of bodybuilding coaches. So the first question will be, what you can wish to our students to be the best trainers during the education?
Hey man, you know what, thanks for the opportunity. You know, it's really, really cool to be able to come to the PowerTech booth here with FEMO and get an opportunity to talk with you
Thank you.
To have an opportunity to address your following. To answer your question, I think it's, wow, when you think about trying to work in the realm of education, you're talking about helping to shape and develop young minds that are not only looking to be helped in the path of increase, but also for the purposes of aiming to learn so they can increase others. When you can teach or encourage someone to learn how to use their skills and develop them, and to develop a skill set to, in an effort, be encouraging to others and to help others reach goals that they may have thought to be impossible prior to having the experiences encountering you. I think it's a tremendous honor, and it's definitely a practice that is really, really, really respectable. So in an effort to encourage the young minds that are working with you and working within the Leader School of Education, I would encourage them to be very clear and passionate about the idea of working to reach and service the best good. My advice is to continue to stay focused and encouraged in aiming to do the best good and the most good going forward.
What can you wish to our graduated guys? How to become great trainers, and maybe you can give a little motivation to become a great trainers?
Well, here's the thing. I don't think you can give motivation. I think you can be very encouraging, but I think motivation comes from the person, the individual in question, and their willingness to connect with the thing that matters to them most. You know, I think you don't have to look very far for motivation, because motivation is inside of you. It's the reason why you want to be a good trainer. It's the reason why you want to aspire to be at the top of your class. I think for me, a lot of the things that I'm asked to do today when talk about motivation is really, you know, an effort to explain how it was that I was able to connect with the thing that was important to me about doing the thing that I wanted to do the most. So I think when you are connected with that thing, you become that much more empowered to be motivating, because you are motivated, you know? And I think the way you find your motivation is, has all to do with being able to recognize what is truly important to you. So we look around outside and we see things like, wow, you know what, that thing right there, that really resonates well with me, recognizing the thing that already inside of me that wills me to want to be able to excel and to do better. So I think every great trainer, every great coach is going to be a person that really, really recognizes how much it matters to them to understand these complex sciences and to be able to make those complex sciences readily accessible to the masses of people that may not want to know a whole lot about math, may not be able to break it down as much, but they come to you, you know, to take your passion, your drive, your willingness to do it, to make that more complex information readily accessible to the common person. Every child, you know, thinks about the future. Every child aspires to be as big as their dad one day, or even bigger.
Yeah.
You know, every child thinks about finding purpose and meaning, being able to do something that allows them to speak to the idea of being the most fruitful, the most positive, the most good. It made that aspiration readily accessible to me in some very easily attainable ways that spoke to me specifically. I think acting, bodybuilding, drawing, all of these things are an expression of an artistic mind that I think was alive with me and that I was aware of, you know, as far back as I care to think about and can, as far back as I can remember. So the animation and the comic books and the character development and stuff that I'm kind of engaged in today with Dynamic Muscle Comics and Chronicles of Tenkai and those things, I think are a more vivid expression of that, yeah. You know? So the creative mind is definitely real, and I'm very, very, very excited to be able to share it in the ways that I am today through Chronicles of Tenkai and Dynamic.